Welcome back everyone. So in this video, let's talk about the return from the function. So right now I'm not returning anything from this function. So what I will get? I will get undefined. So let's just try to return something here. So here I'm returning true. So if whenever I'm calling this function, then I will get a true, right? This function is returning true. So it's not necessary that each and every function should return a value. You can return a number, you can return a boolean, you can return an object from a function, or you can also return a function from a function. Okay, so that is the definition of callback function, which we will talk later. But functions can exist in different ways. So let's call this function add. I'm passing a, okay, and then I'm having a property inside this function, this dot add b. Don't get scared with the name of this object here. And here, what I'm doing, I'm returning a plus b, and b I'm passing here. Okay, and from here I'm returning right. This is what we are doing. What this function is returning? This function is returning another function. Or instead of binding this function, you can have an expression at b. Let's make some difference here. At b, right? So this is like there is some outer function, some inner function, and how will I call this function? So when I will call this function add, I'm passing 2. So what I will be getting? I will be getting this add b function, right? So let's try to play with this function and we will try to understand how the function returns. So whenever I'm writing the function, so what all things are happening here? So what is this fn1? fn1 is actually representing another function which is returned from the outer function. You can see this, and there are three scope because the closure is also added, and it is having one object property which is having a2. Let's talk about that later. But here I'm calling add function, so add function is returning another function. So this fn1 is representing a function returned by calling another function. So function can return another function also, right? Now you can call this function again, because now we are getting the value fn1 and passed another argument 3. So in this case you will get the value 5, because now it's going to add the value, right? So function can return another function. Function can return any primitive type, or function are just a function doesn't return anything. You can write a function which is not doing anything, which is not returning any value. It's not necessary that function always return. They can return the void, it means nothing, right? So here this function is actually returning value, which we understood, but it can be simply something like this. It's not doing anything. You can do whatever you want, right? So whenever you wanted to return something, then just return that function. Here it can be, this can be a variable, this can be a function, this can be an object, or this can be some null or undefined, whatever you see, think of. We generally don't return null or undefined. We return only object, functions, primitives, true, false, numbers or something. And then while getting this, so consider there is nothing like an inner function. We are just calling this, and here I'm returning true. So in this value, I will get the true value, and in the later I can check if value is true, then do this, do that, right? So you can return an object also which is being calculated by something else. So here this is the x object and you are assigning a to it, whatever you are passing. So it is creating that object and it is returning that object. Or instead of that, you can write the same code in a single line, right? Okay, so you can also return a function from a function. That is something a little bit trivial or tricky, because we haven't talked about all those kind of scenarios. So consider this is a function, right? This is taking one argument cb. In that case, so here you are doing some calculation. We are just calculating x equal to 9 plus some 7, and here you are calling cb and passing the argument x. So what this cb is? Cb is nothing but some argument, and you are actually trying to call that. So from the outer function, you are actually returning another function. So how you will call this function? It's a little tricky, right? Outer. And this is going to be a function, right? Okay, while calling this outer function, you will get the value of x. This is a typical callback exists in JavaScript, and we are going to talk about callback in the array pro, type for each, filter, map, reduce, all these methods. So outer I am calling, and I'm passing function as an argument. This is a complete a single argument, which is function, right? And what this function is doing? This function is passing one variable. This function is returning one variable, and we are just printing that. Okay, so this also exists something like this, right? So if you think about console.dir about the outer, what it is having? It is having function, and it is a same normal function, right? But while calling this function, let's call this function. When you will call it, then you are actually not specifying callback, right? Correct? Either you check if callback is not a type of function, then return null or something, right? So you will get an error. So what we can do, this is the function we created. Now we are actually trying to call it. So we need to pass a function argument, or either create another function and pass it. Right? Now in the outer function, pass the add function. Okay? Now it will work because you are passing now a function as an argument. Right? Now the better definition is, let's add a function here. And what it is doing, dot log x, and we are getting the summation of 9 plus 7, right? This is how we are actually calling the function, by passing function as an argument. And this function, so this is the parameter, right? And here we are calling it. So this function is returning another function, and with some argument, and we are defining that. Okay, so if you talk about a simple set timeout, what how it look like, set interval, set timeout, these all are accepting one function as an argument and the time. So what they are saying, they will execute this function after this particular time, particular set of time, right? Set interval, all these are actually callback functions. This is a set timeout is already defined in JavaScript. If you just do console.dir set timeout, why the autocomplete doesn't work here? So set timeout is already a native function. Okay, So this is a native function, and what it is doing, it is accepting two arguments. One is the function which you wanted to execute, and another is a timeout milliseconds. Okay. Similarly, we have a set interval. All these methods are doing the same thing. Okay. That's it. Thanks, everyone.